Nice, I will check. Check those later. Okay. Let's make sure this works. Cool. Alright.
Crash Bandicoot 2. Cortex Strikes Back.
Let's do it. Press start. We all know the drill. Hopefully I don't get a bad time this time. If I mess up somewhere in like the first warp room, I'll just reset because it's just at the start of the game. Oh, okay. Careful with the terrain there. Okay, that was funky. Okay, that's fine. Why does it keep doing that? Come on. Nice. That was a very solid start. Okay, let's keep this up.
Hello.
Nice. Hi.
How you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Alright, let's see. What are you streaming?
Cash Banuka. Gringotts Steakhouse.
That one's still the funniest one. Oh, look! It's... Cash Banuka Gringotts Steakhouse. I love that, bro. His relic video.
Yeah.
Was it, what was Crash Re wrapped?
Something like that.
What do you call It's About Time?
I don't... Well, I know... I think on stream he had his... The name as, like... Tits Around Tim or something.
Wait, did he not do that?
Wait, what?
Did he not do that... Did he not do that on... for his video?
I don't know if he did anything for the video.
Well, I'm not well, I would be surprised if he did it.
Oh, come on. I got this first try last time. There we go. I didn't want that. It's fine.
Oh.
Okay, I think I know why it makes it slow. Invincibility just kinda completely negates the slide spinning trick. It just doesn't work. Is you have invincibility.
Oh, because I guess you're running up at the same speed, I guess.
Something like that.
By the way, did you know, I think Nick All-Stars is already out for some regions.
Yeah, I think people have, like, early access or something.
I know HBox has it.
Yeah.
It's just like... It's like, did he ask for that? Like, it's kind of funny to think that.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I would like to have early access to Nickelodeon All-Stars Brawl.
I'd like to have the funny SpongeBob fighting game.
Best Jigglypuff player.
Yeah.
I think Little Z has it.
Yeah.
This is weird.
What, the game, or...?
Just the way this is happening.
Yeah. It's a little bit.
I'm just watching things.
Oh, okay, that was almost a mistake.
The snapper demands 2 sacrifices.
I'll check the streams later, but they should be all good.
I noticed like a few skips. Mm. I'll just hope none of it gets worse, gets bad.
Yeah.
Worst case scenario is I'm gonna have to explain shit.
Yeah. Hopefully it just happens during the minor parts.
Like, just, maybe like, just basic combat, like, against mooks.
Yeah.
At that point, it'd be like, whatever.
Yeah.
It'll reduce my grinding by half a second.
Perfect. Oh, come on. Okay.
Oh boy. We're almost at the 12-hour mark.
Oh, in the Kingdom Hearts 1?
No. We're at 13-hour mark.
Oh.
12-hour mark until 8. Okay, let me put it like this. Dawn of the final day.
Oh, right, okay, yeah. Yeah.
This will be interesting.
Yep, that will be. Okay, can I not fail spectacularly on this level this time?
Let's see what it says. Stretching.
Okay. I might be a bit sparing on my slide spins here because it's not worth the risk sometimes. Okay, I know there's a pit here. Yeah. Good. Okay. Checkpoint. Well, bonus. But yeah. I don't know if the bonuses count as checkpoints in the original games. Ah. Come on. Come on. Oh my god, okay. That was close. Okay, jump, spin, jump. Hit the things, damn it. Okay, that works. Yeah, let's keep this up.
Thinking about it.
Think about contemplating life. Got hits. Okay, I gotta go there so I don't have to go back past the checkpoint.
Randomly found a video on YouTube. It's of an interesting, like, upcoming horror game.
Oh, really? No.
It's called Inscription. It's basically just a card game.
I see.
But, like, its lore is interesting just by looking at it. Right back.
Okay. Should be good. Speeding through the level.
Good. Forgot about. Oh yeah, the game is basically like a advanced version of another game they're working on.
Oh, okay.
Basically a tech demo.
Yeah. Fair enough.
The game is called Sacrifices Must Be Made. Interesting thing with Sacrifice Must Be Made was like basically you had to even things out, you kinda had to do some kind of drastic thing. By that I mean it would basically at one point it gives a knife and it's just like do this in order to even it out, right?
Okay.
The guy basically gouges his eye. Player, and it's a first-person thing, so the right your right side of the eye can't be seen.
Man,
it's kind of like freaky.
Yeah, it does sound freaky.
Cool, but freaky.
God.
Oh,
Okay. Yeah, I always forget what burn is to, like, go fast on the bear. Oh, of course, of course. I never get that on my first try. Damn it. Alright, please. Oh, come on! Just get the boxes. That is so much easier in Insane, like, it's ridiculous. I feel like they just made the animal hitboxes in Insane larger in general. I'm wasting too much time on this. Finally. That wasn't even supposed to be hard. Okay, the rest of the level should be fine. Oh, yeah. Okay. Dude. Yeah, they definitely made the hitboxes larger. There we go. Okay, that really shouldn't have taken that long. That was kind of a crap start to warp to. Okay, I should be able to save a lot of time on Snowbiz, because last time I just died like 20 times for no reason. Oh. Yeah! That was cool. I like how the 3D sections at the start of the snow levels are like 2 seconds long. So what are you up to anyway?
Me? Right now, not much. I was kind of looking at shit.
Oh, that TNT jump is so satisfying. Okay, no, that's fine, that's fine. Oof.
I'm eating dinner.
Yeah. I'll take this bit slow, it's not worth the risk. Okay, that was way better than the last run. Okay, there's nothing back there in snow, but I gotta. If I ever run this game again, I gotta remember that. Dude, ice physics. Very clean. Yeah, I shaved off like 7 minutes from that. Oh my god.
Wow, seriously?
Is Scrappy online or?
No, video.
No, I mean, yeah, but like, I'm just wondering.
See.
Okay. There we go back. Now I gotta remember this time I can't get the boxes. To just ignore them. What? Okay, sound effects just died.
Live.
The hell? Okay, sound effects have been weird. Oh, damn it.
It's scripted so you can't win. Supposed to be a live tutorial. Anyway, somehow I really close to win, the game just cheats.
Yeah. Oh wait, crap, I need
to like,
restart.
Oh, you're about to win? Let me fix that.
Oh, it's gonna waste time. Dude. Can I okay, please. I don't want to start choking. No. Yeah, just don't get the checkpoints. I hope that's how the death roots work in this game. Dude. This is not a level I should be struggling with, come on.
What level are we on?
Crash. Yeah, that's what I wanted you to do last time, okay. Please stop. Damn it, dude! I guess you just can't die, period. I thought... whatever. It usually doesn't matter until you get to the first checkpoint.
That's funny. The villain of the story might as well just be a forest spirit who likes to roleplay.
Yeah.
He puts on like a, to be like a boss fight, he puts on a prospector mask.
Mm-hmm.
Talks like one.
Nice.
He's LARPing.
LARPing is such a funny word.
It's also really funny because he's, what's the word? It's like the guy watching in this video described it basically as a guy just is like a big D&D campaign.
Yeah.
Because the guy telling the story, because your villain is pretty much being a DM.
Oh! Damn it.
You find that hilarious.
Yeah. Oh, that's bad. No. Everything is sad. Dude, I don't want to restart this at this point. This is, oh my god.
Is our thing going worse?
I'm just doing badly now. Actually, you know what? Let's just start this whole thing over. Screw this.
Yeah.
I'm not happy with how that was going.
Draw Monster Cardo.
Let's try that again. I don't want to keep restarting because I'll be here all night, but it was early enough. Sucks. As soon as I got into Warp Room 2, everything just fell apart.
Well.
Don't hit the checkpoint. Okay. Don't hug the wall.
He's really like seriously character to like 20. The bad guy is just really he's just really into it.
Nice.
I'm like, what are you doing?
Clearly having fun.
Aboard.
Hi, TLBG14, if that's the name. Sup, my dude. Yeah, I had to restart the run because I was not happy with how it was going. No, this is, well, I guess this is the, like, Sony's emulator, but, like, I'm playing this through the PS3. So, D-pad only, yay! Okay, I might have to get, make myself get hit more than once in Snowgo because I don't want the invincibility. Gets so many masks in this game, it's kind of insane.
Masks.
Yes, indeed. Yeah, actually that works, that's fine. That is a lot of text you just posted. Oh, see if I can find time to read that during a load screen or something. Oh, come on,
actually,
dude.
I'll see if I can read it for you.
Dude. This is not supposed to be this hard, come on.
Oh, I can't. Oh, because I was like that, I can't see it. Oops.
That's fine. Something about... Hold on. Okay, so that one has the... This stage has the nitro switch at the back. PCS3, aka PS3 emulator, is compatible with the PS1 Classic Collection ROMs, aka the Crash Games and FF8, Final Fantasy 8. Okay.
Okay.
It's interesting.
New Intel.
New Intel. Okay, so.
Let me check.
I need to do the time trial thing here and then do the level normally. PS2 games.
Soon my Twitty goes and gets too messy. This is going, at least my run's going really well.
Yeah.
We just gotta hope it stays, like, okay.
Yeah, right. There's always the worry of choking.
Oh, I'm not worried about me choking, I'm worried about my footage choking.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah.
Honestly, the place where I'm the most scared in terms of actual recording is just the optional bosses.
Also, yeah, you mentioned PS2 games not working on the emulator thing. That's why I want more PS2 games to be re-released, because it's so annoying to have to set my old PS2 up for things. It's just, it's a different, like, old consoles in general, like, you have to have, like, different stuff set up. I'll read that following post art in a bit. Actually, no, you should be able to see the message now, right?
Oh, I closed it because I thought it was moo.
Oh, come on.
I'm sorry. I'm a bad friend. Alright, we're okay, let me try again. I'll pick one on Squid. Your only option is PCS2.
Yeah, I even done some stuff with it. I tried doing some stuff with PlayStation emulators in the past, and it's just kind of annoying. They're not really that fun to deal with, I'll be honest. This is because the PS3 emulator is using an architecture of the Japanese and American PS3. Yeah. Well, I remember hearing that the PS3 in general uses kind of weird architecture that took a while for devs to get used to. And that's why early PS3 games are poorly optimized.
Or why it's generally hard to use in general.
Yeah.
I'm not sure Crystal was joking about this one, but from what I heard, it was intentionally made hard.
Was made hard?
The PlayStation architecture.
I don't know, but that sounds really dumb if that's the case. Because you don't want making games for a console to be difficult just for the sake of it. That's just dumb.
I have no idea what would be their reasoning.
It better be a damn good reason if that's true.
Then again, I got to see Sony being kind of like just stupid in general, since they're not the most wise making decision. They're the wise decision makers.
Not always. I feel like
they're just stupid or stingy as shit.
Yeah, I think the thing that Sony struggles from a lot, I feel, is just having a big ego. Because like they have like before the PS3, like before that, they had the PS2, which was like really popular. And
well, I think that was like one of the best selling consoles of all time.
Yeah, and even then the PS1 as well, like that did really well. So I feel like they kind of just had their heads up their asses at that point, and I feel like that's kind of happening again after the PS4 did so well.
Oh, did you think, it'll be fine about the PS5s and such?
Yeah.
If that's the case, then what the fuck? Yeah, you're lucky you have good games, Sony.
Yeah, right? That's pretty much the only reason I still, like, play their consoles. Like, they have good exclusives and stuff.
I mean, that's the reason why PS4 won the console war between that and Xbox One, right?
More or less, yeah.
Because, like, Xbox, from what I know I'm not an Xbox player, but, like, it's just, like, from what I know, they barely have anything worth that we're calling their own.
Not really. Most of the big stuff that they have is multiplayer or like Halo or whatever. So I don't know. They don't really have that much.
Gran Turismo.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah.
Or that PlayStation actually. Regardless. Point. Point being, they don't get any Xbox. Might be more consumer friendly, but they're definitely not. But they definitely need more exclusives.
Yeah, because out of the three, like in terms of like consumer, friendliness or whatever you call it,
Well, that's cool.
Okay, I need to do this right.
Trying to do like a quick like spin jump trick.
Yeah.
So it'll break it instantly while you still keep your bounce.
Yeah, I'm trying it. It's not easy. Screw it, I'll just do it normally. Okay, that's fine. Sony, we'll be fine. PS5 users. I'll see. Can you read that? RC mouse batteries. Yeah.
Demos? What is that?
I don't know.
Explanation, please.
Okay. Good.
Will the boulder just jump over those crates?
Yeah, they will.
It doesn't do that in the insane though, does it?
I don't think so. I know they changed quite a bit.
I don't call it bouncing.
Yeah, I think they made the stages like a bit more lenient. Damn it, dude.
And the crush crates.
Yeah.
Those are fun. Well, I'll see if this guy gives a better explanation to what the CMOS battery is. Otherwise, I'll have to look it up. I'm just waiting so I don't potentially miss anything.
Yeah. Okay. That worked out.
Does it have a battery to keep the system from having the clock go to zero while the disk is... Didn't they fix that in an update, though, lately?
For PS5?
Well, I know they at least did for the PS4, but, like, oh. I'd imagine, where it's just, like, it basically has a kill clock on the inside.
Oh. So, like, it kills things?
Once it goes to zero, it basically, like, it's what it originally was like. I think it was, like, once it hits a certain time, it goes to zero, but which also keeps trophies from being read.
Oh, so it just... Oh.
But as a result of this, it's not allowed to. It can't. It needs it, and the it can't connect to like a server or something like that. It'll basically just crash it.
Oh, so okay. So they fixed it's that.
It's a kill time. Yeah, from what I heard, it's a kill timer potentially.
Damn, that's unfortunate.
At least they fixed that with a PS4. I don't know about PS5. I didn't even know if PS5 had that.
Yeah, that is weird though.
You know what I mean? Let me check the
problem. Same thing for PS3.
Yeah. Oh, what, the kill clock?
Apparently.
I think I described it relatively well enough.
Only for disc copies, okay.
Oh, really? It was one for disc copies? I thought it was for both.
Hmm.
What is this PS4 I'm thinking about?
Don't know.
What I know, the battery does take a good while before it even happens, but still.
Right.
The fact that it'll basically brick your console.
Yeah, oh my god.
Oh good, you're doing the best thing about Crash.
Well.
PS4 and PS5 Crash are both copies. Until it tells me anything, I'm going to start my run of the Xenoblade Chronicles.
The first game?
Yeah. Okay. I played too early this year, so.
Oh.
Oh, right. Switch OLED's coming out soon.
Yep.
Remember that was a thing?
I don't really have much interest in that, I'll be honest.
People have interest in it?
Yeah.
No!
It's just a game to speedrun. What would that be?
Oh, this should be good. Parasite
Eve? I've never played it.
Never even heard of it.
I've heard of it. It's a horror game, isn't it?
Well, that immediately turns me away because I don't like horror.
It's a Squaresoft game? Okay. Back before they were consumed by the Enix.
That's a statement.
I mean, it's not incorrect.
Let's see, did I transfer over my thing from the... Yeah.
It's a mix of horror and RPG. I might look into the game, but I doubt I'd speedrun something like that. That's not really something I feel like I'd do.
God, I love this title screen for Xenoblade Chronicles because it doesn't even say Xenoblade Chronicles until you hit a button.
I should make it clear here. I'm not a professional speedrunner by any means. Takes 8 hours casually, 2 to 3 hours for speedrunners. Damn. I'm not a speedrunner by any means. I can only really do runs of like very like a handful of games. This is definitely not a norm you'll see from me.
You just wanted to do this because it's one of your favorite games.
I don't know if I'd go that far, but it's I can reasonably get through Crash 2. Well, more or less like most of the Crash games pretty quickly, but especially this one. Well, relatively speaking, I kind of failed last time, but yeah.
Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition.
Okay, Barrett, can we please not fail getting the first few boxes again?
I can New Game Plus my run, but I'm not gonna do that. As a special bonus for having played Xenoblade Chronicles 2, you could start with extra money. You cannot collect after starting.
If you're getting the PS1 version, no, it's split into two discs. Well, what versions are there? Is there like a modern release? PSN version is much faster? Fair enough. Yeah, I'll look into Parasite Eve, but I can't promise I'll play it.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, okay, I'll live with that. I'll live with that.
Problem.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Not bad, really.
No. For you, it was okay?
God, I love this game so much. Sorry.
Yeah.
I'm just looking at the intro cutscene again. I'm just so glad they re-released this.
Yeah.
I think you can already see Telethia just floating around the Bionis in this opening.
Huh. It's kind of fascinating, like, seeing things like that after, like, you finished the game. Just knowing the context.
Yeah.
I almost did that first try.
Yeah, I can say that without much context, at least.
Yeah.
You know, I'll also say I definitely think that this is definitely a game that kind of needed this kind of re-release.
Oh yeah, otherwise it would have been stuck on the Wii and the new 3DS forever.
And Wii U to an extent.
Yeah, but the Wii U was like super underperformed. Like it no one really bought it.
Don't buy it.
Hmm.
We're one of a handful of people who do.
Yeah, right. And even then, I don't even use it to play Wii U stuff anymore. I use it to play GameCube and Wii games, and even then.
Yeah, emulator.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck this cat. I hit my cat because he's just hissing.
Real. Okay, we're on. Good time. Oh.
Full eyes over. Hey. The Mechon are attacking. Also, I think I am dead.
Right, plot-wise, your officer in New York who was, I am too.
Yeah, spaghetti. Sorry, I keep forgetting the Just a Pancake video.
Who's aimed to kill a mutated stage actor who's possessed to kill humanity with mitochondria. Okay, seems interesting.
Gunman is really awesome. Hey, Dixon. I'm Umkar.
Oi!
Man, replaying this game really makes you look at characters a different way.
Oh, yeah.
That's the best I can say.
Yeah, I don't know if,
anyone who watches our VOD or anything is gonna...
Yeah, I don't know if our friend has played Xenoblade.
Or even has an interest.
Yeah, so I'll just be careful about that.
That's why I'm being as vague as I possibly can. I pretty much sworn to myself to only, like, just sporadically talk about it without giving context. Or just not talk. Oh, he played Xenoblade X.
Oh, okay, man.
And I'm just waiting for it to get re-released on the Switch.
Same. I mean, I got that for Christmas one year, but I never played it.
I only played, like, a few minutes of it, only because I've had to regain the play at the time. Basically, I started playing it at a bad time.
Yeah. So I was going to play it sometime after... Huh?
And also because Wii U.
Right. I was going to play it after I finished the first game after a point, but I just never did.
And now all we can do is hope.
Yeah, I'd rather play it on the Switch if I could. I mean, I'd rather play, like, pretty much anything on the Switch nowadays.
Monado and Chance, let's go.
Monando.
God, I love this game. I love this music so much.
Ooh! Okay, that was really funky, but that worked.
Monado and Chance! By the way, something fun I learned about New Game Plus is, at the start here, Monkar is a special outfit.
Oh, nice.
I can't tell you what it is.
Interesting.
You know what the outfit is, though.
Wait, what?
The boss that gave you a lot of trouble.
Oh boy, nice.
Yeah, he's basically like that.
Okay.
Or he looks something very similar to that.
Also note there will not be a re-release due to the offer of Parasite Eve. I'm assuming you meant to say never. Oh, Novel? Not like in the second game? Okay, interesting.
Gotta let the dogs back in.
Who let the dogs in? Woof.
Dead. I'm dead. Eh. Man, it's really fun. Man, you know what really shows that how good Xenoblade Chronicles is a game when all they needed to do was improve the graphics?
Yeah, pretty much. Because that was the only thing that kind of got a little bit iffy in some ways. And that was more due to the Wii's hardware more than the game itself.
The visuals?
Yeah. Like, you can tell that the Wii held it back.
Yeah. I mean, I'm glad we got it, though. That's yeah, a big thing.
Definitely. So, I don't know if I'll play Definitive. Like, I'd have to have a reason to want to play the game again, but I'm glad it's a thing that exists.
Well, at this point, I think the only reason you is without giving the game a big weight is for Future Connected.
Yeah, and I don't know if I want to spend, like, full price on the game just for that.
You want me to look for, like, a eShop sale, like, on...
I mean, if I can, if it's available for really cheap, I might consider it, but...
Yeah, then again, the other day, you just said you spent, like, so much money.
Yeah, no, I don't feel comfortable buying anything else for a while.
Present, then.
Maybe?
That'd be a good cheap way to get away with it.
I guess.
I mean, you can also do Xenoblade Chronicles 2.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I feel like that might be in my better interest to ask for Xenoblade 2 at this point.
It's a completely different game.
Yeah.
And plus, I think you can appreciate it more because you played one.
Right. I'm not against playing definitive edition at some point, but not now.
That was a long time ago, wasn't it?
What, playing the original?
Yeah, that was like at least 2 years ago?
Something like that. It doesn't feel that long to me.
Oh, I love this image here of Monkar having all the lasers on him because it reminds me of a meme, right?
It's like the Tetris 99 thing.
Yes. Exactly, just shows all the luck on the one player, but it shows Monkar freaking out.
Speaking of 99 games, I should play more Pac-Man 99, because I played that when it came out, and then I just kind of stopped.
I haven't touched that yet. So I love this overview. I love this sweeping view of like after the battle at Sword Valley, where it just shows like the world a little bit to show exactly where we are.
Yeah.
God, this world has the only class has such good world building.
Yeah, I'd agree with that.
X. Hey, Xenoblade can take. Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition. Although I can tell you that I believe the Nappon in Future Connected got a little bit of the Xenoblade Chronicle 2s. By that I mean they started talking a lot more like how Nappon talked in Xenoblade Chronicles 2.
Oh, okay.
That's why you hear them going like meh a lot. Oh, this shot right I'm the very first scene with Chulk. I remember when they showed this off at during the Nintendo Direct. Like the shot of Chulk laying down with a dragonfly.
Yeah.
And like, oh my god, I was so hyped up from looking at that, you know?
Yeah.
But again, I also recognize the just the overview shot. Cause like the very first thing you see is Fallen Arm.
Right.
NM69!
NM69!
You're right, that is funny.
I think I was tempted to make a meme video about that at one point.
Just NM69!
Yeah. Could have been really
and also
stupid.
They made Time to Fight sound good in this version.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I forgot about that perp.
It's not a Metcon, it's just a Krabble! We did the Metcon on my shell.
Oh.
God, I love Shulk and Ryan.
Yeah, right.
I know how
game?
To play the game.
That was weird.
Ryan, get the aggro off me, please.
Okay.
Thank you. Backslash! Shulk's best attack.
Yeah.
And you pretty much start the game with it. They give a really good arc to start the game with.
Yeah, that is a really good move.
And it also helps that Shulk has light heal.
I think there's a secret one up if you fall down there, but...
Let's not lose our heads, though!
Yep. Nicely done.
Mm. I also just love how dynamic this combat is.
Yeah.
Oh, one change they did in the Definitive Edition is if you're positioned correctly where your art will like exploit a weak it will like be at max damage, it'll give a little alert.
Oh.
So like if you're actually behind the enemy, backslash will have like a little exclamation point next to it.
Oh yeah, I've heard that they added some things like that so that you know better of like what the best move is to do.
Right. Again, it's for when you're gonna get max damage.
Right. I also heard they made it more clear how to get how to change the future or whatever, and like during those parts.
When you get visions.
Yeah, visions.
Yeah.
Cause I always struggled with that. Oh, what?
I believe the idea is like you're supposed to use your Venado arts on the right end or based on what you see.
Right.
You know, I love the
Crash Phobia. Hi, self.
Hi, Self. What did Self say?
Crash 4 be like. Also, hi. I missed a couple boxes somehow. I don't know how that happened. Pretty sure I got everything. That's gonna cost me.
Oh man, I love the area. I love the song for when you get inside of Colony 9.
I know what happened. I went too fast and the boulder didn't destroy the nitro. Damn it, dude.
They also made it easier for you to track quests.
Mm. Oh yeah, I heard about that.
My god, I love this soundtrack so much. I think I miss it.
Jason orgasm on stream.
What? Whoa, damn!
Yeah, jumping on over boost pads because I totally meant to do that. Okay, destroy those, please.
My backstabber achievement for starting an attack, starting a fight with a back attack.
I just say, I am so glad they fixed that. And then saying the fact that, like, it has to be on screen, otherwise it never got destroyed. Like, that's so stupid.
We have ostrich syndrome. I'll tell you this, movement is a little slower in Xenoblade Chronicles 2.
It looks like it.
In terms of the combat, anyways.
Right.
Positioning is much more crucial, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, it looks a bit more, like, slow and methodical.
Yeah, it is.
If you can't see it, it doesn't exist. Crash 2 PS1. Yeah, that's just Crash 1, 2, and... That's just a trilogy in general. Because, like, the thing is with the, Nitro Destruction Switches in these games, they're programmed in a way that it only specifically destroys those boxes, and like if there were like boxes around nitros when you hit it.
Oh, I already got a gold chest.
Those boxes won't be broken, so that's kind of stupid.
I already found a gold chest.
Nice. Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Hit Ryan. All right.
That was a waste. That was kind of a waste of time. I'm convinced it was because of the boulder.
Oh yeah, I just remembered something. Because I have a completed save already on my file, I can use any of the outfits. I can use any of the equipment pieces as like cosmetics I found.
Hmm.
Which is good, so I don't have to. So I can put on like swimsuit equipment without looking at like without having to wear the swimsuit equipment.
Yeah, boy.
The only weapon you can't put a skin over is the Monado.
Yeah. Damn it. That was really dumb.
Also, good thing for Ryan, because I got that thing, Ryan is already getting a massive power up because they already found a crusher, which gives him aggro at 3.
Yeah.
I'm like, let's go, Ryan!
Yeah, boy. Also, just for those wondering, I'm gonna try to have a stream set up for the Smash thing tomorrow.
I wonder if I should put on the outfit from the thing or in from Future Connected, or if I just should keep the normal outfit.
That was intentional, just so you know.
You, Harry, you vaguely remember what the Future Connected outfit looks like, right?
Not offhand.
It's more, here, I'm gonna put it on so I can describe it better to you.
Okay.
It basically looks like a much more, like, modernized version of his original outfit. He has, like, it's more like a hoodie with, long blue pants and a little circle belt. And pretty cool look. Basically, his outfit matches a lot more. There's none of that purple there, unfortunately. He doesn't have, like, the sweater.
Yeah.
I like this outfit a lot, too.
I'd have to look at it again.
I'll definitely tell you this. I definitely like Melia's outfit.
Mm-mm.
That's not me being biased, shut up.
probably gonna have to watch the reveal tomorrow on my phone at work. That's gonna be interesting. Yeah, I've noticed that, like, from a lot of people I've talked to, like, the reveal is happening while they're at school, they're doing work, or they're just busy with other things.
It's because they always do this stuff at 2 in the morning. Or not 2 in the morning, you know what I mean?
Yeah. So...
I'm just lucky... Well, because work's been so slow for me that I'm able to get away with this.
Right.
Wild down! Man, what a bunch of jokers. I love Ryan so much.
Oh my god, that was way too close.
Let me see what happened.
You're probably gonna miss it.
Well, okay, maybe I did. What did I miss?
I was like not even that. I was like 2 feet away from the toxic barrel.
Then I think I saw it for a split second, but missed it. Yeah!
Whoa!
They never stood a chance.
It'd just be funny, just like... Sylph just, like, reacts to the, Smash reveal and just goes crazy at work. And, like, everyone's just like, what are you doing?
Nick's done that at restaurants, apparently.
Wait, what?
Nick apparently was like that at restaurants.
Just imagine all the weird looks.
Like... Why did I popple, really?
Wait, what?
Game.
Oh, yeah, just imagine all the weird looks you'd get.
Since I know Sylph has played Xenoblade Chronicles 1, I forget if he said he's played 2.
Not paying attention to the stream, what is this? Us doing the KHDA fights?
Oh, hi Nick!
But I mean, it's hoping it's not Sora because I wouldn't be able to contain that Yeah.
Well, I'm not looking at any kind of, like, rumors or anything.
I need to.
So being as in the dark as possible. Even like, slight, like, ideas might mess with me, so...
Yeah.
To me, the best expectation is no expectation. In terms of this.
Yeah, it is no? Mainly speculation right now. I've noticed that a lot of people, like, going by Twitter, like, a lot of people want Sora, and I don't know, but, yeah.
God, this freaking caterpile keeps toppling me. I also remember Tiffany Conroy's rule about battles in Xenoblade Chronicles. Try to limit the amount of enemies you're fighting as possible.
Right. Yeah. Because
you can get overwhelmed really easily.
Yeah, pretty much. Especially early game, if you're not careful.
Yes, yeah. Especially since you don't have any AoE arts at the time, and even then you don't want Shulk using those.
Right.
Oh, good, Affinity Coins.
Oh, God.
Freaking Shulk, he's getting toppled.
Oh, that was a mistake. Yeah, that's too far.
That's the reminder of in later in the game when they actually make the you can't make a rainbow without Ryan joke.
Okay.
I know, just a pancake did that as a joke, but that's the actual line.
Can you read that, please?
Maybe someday when I finish the entire Tales of franchise, we'll finally get around Xenoblade.
Okay, I'm not gonna get the...
Good luck with that!
Yeah. So, how many Tales of games, have you not played, like...
As far as I know, Nick hasn't played that many. He just is familiar with them.
Right.
Is that right?
Oh boy. That's not a good sign.
I found a giant hornet.
Speaking of cage-free data fights, though, I honestly don't feel that much more confident about Xehanort than I did when we were recording.
Well, did you practice any at all?
No, but I did look up some videos.
Alright. Oh, now I'm actually at Colony 9. It's playing Hometown. I love this song so much. It's so homey. That's why.
Yeah. Oh, God, okay.
Like, that point, it's all home, but still.
Right. I mean, it's doing its job.
Yep. I found a landmark.
Don't eat me! Cool.
Let's see how data zone answer took me a long time to get right, Self said.
Yeah, especially since I'm doing on crit. I can tell you right now, I think Data Xehanort has taken over 2 hours so far, at least. And I
As long as it doesn't get you mad, as long as it's not as maddening as it was for
Marluxia or whatever, yeah. Marluxia was just kind of irritating.
This, Legendia, Zillia 1 and 2, Zestiria, and finish Lucaria, Nick said.
Jeez, yeah, have fun with that.
Have fun with that.
Yeah,
where are the Colony 9 residents? Because I need to fill my affinity chart.
Yeah.
Never 3 hours, never put me through that again. I get the feeling that Xehanort won't take any more than 1 hour.
I'm not gonna put a label on it.
I'll put Monopoly money on it.
I'd like it to be less than an hour, but if
I'm that confident, I will bet Monopoly money on you.
That was bad. Okay, I'm right here anyway, but man, that was bad. His Patreon is on the line. No one even gets the joke because it's not gonna be uploaded for a month. I kind of regret, I think at one point we talked about the last Smash character, and I kind of regret that because that's gonna be so out of date when that gets uploaded.
Yeah, right. Well, I'll at least tell people how long our footage, how old our footage is.
Yeah.
I mean, look back at our look back at our Kingdom Hearts 2 footage. That shit is old.
Right.
Yes, Gem Man. I know how to use your Ether Burn.
Oh!
You! To me! Oh yeah! To me!
Oh yeah!
I love doing the Burn shit. I just love hearing their stupid lines.
Yeah, right. The funny animations.
Oh, especially when you speed it up.
Go, go, go! Oh, come on.
I think it's especially funny when you speed it up.
Yeah, right. Dude, why do I suck?
You don't suck.
it feels like it sometimes.
I'm just accepting all the generic quests. They also made just finding quests easier.
I'm just gonna...
For one thing, the mini map update's much faster in this version.
Just go.
I remember when he was over in at the original version and the 3DS version, it takes forever for the minimap to update when you're close to something.
Right.
Very evident when you're the quest person, right point blank, it just loads.
Right. So I can actually get everything on Road to Ruin in one go.
Did you, by the way, did you have a gem skip?
Gem skip,
red gem skip.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, this skip right here, I'm pretty sure if you do it right, it is possible to do an insane, but, like, the different jump physics make it a lot more difficult. That was a shame. So I need to, like, just... Dude, what the heck is this angle? Crash keeps, like moving up.
Leopold and Leopold and Sylvain got their things on my affinity chart.
Yay! All right, cool.
The mini map says there's an MP. Oh yeah, you can actually see Fiora in Dunban's house this early on before you even know her.
Nice. That was an interesting chain of events.
She's sitting in the kitchen right now, actually. I can see her. Yeah. But they're gonna take a quick snap of that.
Alright, come on.
That's not gonna make Shulk look creepy at all.
I need to get on the second platform.
Me doing that's not gonna make Shulk look creepy at all.
Yeah, right. Oh my god almighty. Dude.
Alright, let me get to my collectopedia.
Okay, that doesn't work. The ceiling's too low. I'm wasting too much time on this crap.
I leveled up. I earned the new art. And I got an affinity coin.
No.
Yeah, the mini map does. Yeah, the game does a lot better with like side quests and shit because because the mini map basically tells you where everything is when it's available at the moment.
Dude.
Unfortunately, the only thing I still don't like about this game is when some things acquire weather.
Oh.
Like there's a unique monster in Tepher Lake, I believe. I don't remember if it's Tepher Lake, but it's that lake in the Bionis leg.
Right.
Where like you have to wait for the rain, and then a big Brog shows up.
Right.
Partially worse than Xenoblade Chronicles 2 at points. Because there's a, first of all, I already completed this guy's request. what was the area called?
Oh, yeah, it still says he hates waiting for that side quest, apparently.
Are you talking about the same thing I am about about White Eduardo in the, at the lake? Yeah, I still remember what the unique monster is called. Yay, me.
You got a gold star. Oh, screw you!
Mostly because, like, it's a crapshoot when it's, like, when it's actually gonna start raining at points. In Xenoblade Chronicles 2, when you get to the, Letharian Archipelago, one of the unique monsters you need for, I believe it's for Mithra, and for one of the rare blades, Zenobia, you need to wait for an Aurora to show up, which is very rare. But the only reliable way you have to travel in and out of the Letharian Archipelago constantly until the weather changes to where you need it. Not a pace breaker at all.
Yeah, right.
More so, good luck finding this shit out. Then again, I have no shame admitting when I need to use the wiki at points in Xenoblade Chronicles.
Yeah.
It's a big game, so.
Yeah.
I can't be expected to remember everything.
I'd be impressed if you did.
Yeah, what am I, Chugga? Even Danny, even he gets it wrong. And this is also his favorite game.
Yeah, if a game as long as that is like, you're not gonna remember every little like minute detail.
I'm assuming he researched aim before like his session start.
Probably, yeah.
Well, that also just goes to show why Chuck is such a good LPer.
Right.
Because he thinks ahead.
Right. Ooh! Alright, just go.
Quest complete!
Quest complete.
Oh man, I can't wait to get the faster running eventually. I mean, like, once I get a quick step gem, that'll be really nice.
Yeah.
In Xenoblade Chronicles 2, there's no quick step gem, so how that works, so to boost your speed, your movement speed is, you need to buy deeds, which you only get after increasing your reputation reward.
Right.
Or reputation each, area rather. You get a lot of neat other shit, so it's worth doing it regardless. Getting as much of this game done as I can.
Okay. I'm gonna try for this again, because I want to get this trick.
I also like how, when it in the tutorial screen, how it teaches things, because it, like, it has the characters discussing their attack, their battle patterns.
Mm-hmm.
Like, battle tactics, Shulk. It's like him explaining how his talent art works.
Oh, that! Yeah, I remember that.
My talent art is Turn Strike. It deals a lot of damage and can inflict break on the enemy. The tower gauge fills up when I auto attack, so it's better to auto attack and not just use arts all the time. And then, like, shulking around and having to roll back and forth.
Also, I feel like an idiot because I literally just noticed in the background there's a Cortex Castle in a silhouette.
Oh.
I never noticed that. Okay. I gotta be honest.
I let Ryan bear the brunt of the attacks. He can take a lot more knocks to the head
than
I can.
Oh no! Why?
Yeah, leave it to me. I distract the enemies and draw the aggro while you do damage with backslash. Don't let me down. When Ryan's feeling at the heat a bit, I can use light heal to get him back in the game. Thanks, Shulk, but make sure you don't draw too much aggro yourself. Sometimes you just want to lay out the arts for a while.
Come on, that's totally doable. Do I just need to jump on the box and not spin? This is a waste. I'm wasting so much time doing this. Come on. That is totally possible. I've seen it be done.
Two tips of equipment. Use cosmetic equipment. I like how there's like. I think the best thing about this game is just that you can use cosmetics.
Yeah. This is. I don't know why I'm bothering with this. Like, truthfully.
Oh, yeah, there's a casual mode in this game. I almost forgot about that.
Oh.
It's a tutorial. It says enemies gain too tough to handle. Enabling casual mode lets you lower the difficulty of battles, and it just says how to do it.
Screw it, it's not worth it, dude.
I'm not doing that.
Yo, would that too, but...
Oh yeah, and this is even nice, there's an expert mode. It says, expert mode lets you store a portion of earned experience points for later use, rather than being granted to a character immediately. You can enable it by opening the system with start, going to expert mode, and toggling the option. Expert mode is disabled by default. When expert mode is enabled with the right stick, all further experience gains through quests, discovering landmarks and locations, and gaining achievements will be reserved for later use. The expert mode option system menu, excellent plus, lets you manually adjust party characters' levels.
Mm.
Increasing a character's level will cost reserve XP. Reducing a character's level will convert excess experience points back into reserve experience.
Mm. Monkey!
Basically, it lets you customize your levels in a way.
Screw this.
It basically lets you enable level ups when you feel like you should. So you're not over-leveled, basically.
Aye.
Which is a good way of doing things, because I know, like, one of the things, like, in some RPGs, it is fun to just, absolutely destroy things, but...
Yeah.
In some, it's more, but it's more of a case-by-case basis, but in some, you kind of want an actual challenge.
Yeah. That was a really crusty rotor
like,
around.
Like, to me, it's not that fun, like, completely bodying everything in Kingdom Hearts. It's our nine, rather, not Kingdom Hearts.
In what?
In Xenoblade Chronicles, it's not exactly that fun to, like, one-shot things, enemies.
Yeah, not particularly.
Because, like, they kind of lose their impact if they're just, like, that much.
They become mindless. So it's
yeah.
Like, what it becomes, like, I don't really care anymore.
Yep, right?
Yeah. Alright, can I make up for lost time here? Let's see. Oof. Yeesh!
Let me change the time. Cause I'm just trying to activate it. I'm just trying to do my cleanup in the Colony 9.
Right.
Get everything ready before I start, before I things really pick up, you know?
Yeah, for sure. Book the bar.
I get to appreciate the music more. Hey you, come back here, come back!
I want to keep this mask for a little bit.
I must talk to you.
I
probably be talking to too many named NPCs right now because I need, because that will help me with affinity.
Mm. I can tell you right now, this is going way better than the last stream. That's something. Crash's feet just didn't exist for a minute. Or shoes, rather. Nice. Why does that always happen to me?
What happened?
I just never hit the enemy into the TNT.
Alley-oop?
Alley-oop.
Alley-oop? Alley-oop?
Okay, this is actually a good, decent place to have this.
Is that all the NPCs? Nice. Oh no, I still gotta talk to the girls.
Oh! Okay, pom-pom
what?
That was a good run.
But pom-pom what?
Pom-pom.
Nobody said pom-pom.
Oh no, I was making the sounds because I was like, Akira was going like, oh!
Oh!
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, I wasn't sure what you meant.
Alright, time for one of my favorite cutscenes in the game. The one with Colonel Vanguard just yelling at the two Colony 9 like soldiers.
Move it!
Yeah! Move it!
Scary.
I also love that it plays
Ricky the Legendary Hero Pond during that.
plays
a Ricky Deception song, and it's hilarious.
I gotta be careful about this polar bear.
God, I love... Chuck is right, just how you can pull back the camera in areas like this.
Oh yeah, I did that a lot.
I want to be surprised that games like this is what made me so photogenic.
Maybe.
Cause like, look at these shots you can take.
Oh yeah. I love just seeing good views like that.
Yeah, like, cause like, we're like at the foot of the Bionis, and just like we're in this canyon like area, and you can just look up. You can see parts of. You could just see, like. Stored Valley above us, basically, and yeah. Other parts of the Bionis.
I mean, I'd say, like, for me, games like that definitely made me appreciate stuff like that more.
Yeah. Alright, here's the cutscenes at the start. Here we go.
Oh, God.
I remember how this cutscene looked like in that speed up video.
Yeah, that's what I was referencing.
Man, that.
No, the best thing is,
there it is.
Ryan, dealing with the Monado at, like, super speed.
Yeah. Pull up till the end of the house. How long have you been in the force?
I swear those guys- oh, okay. Easy. I swear those guys shoot faster in this version.
Take the animation.
And time for deafening sound. Yeah, boy. Why did they make that so loud?
Ew, bitch! By the way, fun fact, they didn't remake the song for Definitive Edition.
Oh, it's just the same thing from the original.
Yeah, so why would you- this song's the one that doesn't need to be changed. I think it's funnier this way.
Yeah.
It's like how they didn't change Unfinished Battle either. Mm. You know, the one when Gunban comes in.
Right. Wait, what happened to my- oh, whatever.
Same old colonel. This right, the men will all be dead before they see any action.
That was...
You're not lying without even having a look at the text.
Unbearable is easier than I remember.
Oh, by the way, if you run over to the fence on the right, you can see Ryan doing push-ups with the Ever Soldiers.
Oh, nice.
And he's even wearing whatever gear he has at the time.
I think the main hurdle in this stage is the secret path. Other than that, it's honestly not that bad. I think Crash Dash is harder, honestly. Or not Crash Dash, Crash... whatever the second one was.
Crash Crush?
Yeah, something like that. That being said, here's Totally Bear, so, here we go.
What's up? Please.
Yeah, the... Alright. I gotta focus on this. Oh my god! Good, that's a good start. I know there's a thing to the left in a bit. I'm not chancing a boost, it's not worth it.
Hey.
Oh.
Hey. Cut out.
Ow.
Okay.
Yeah, that wasn't so big.
Dude!
I'll be done with Crash, with Spyro 2 by now.
Wait, what?
If I wasn't so busy recording Kingdom Hearts, I'd probably be done with Spyro 2 by now.
Oh yeah, did you do just one stream of that, or?
So far.
Okay, did you want me to save that, download that too? Because I don't know if you were doing that for Seas or just a casual run.
I was playing it casually, was that one or two sessions? If it was two, you might as well, let me think, actually. Oh, no, it was definitely two, but because the problem was, I did part one. The first part I did was, I finished Spyro 1, and I jumped a little bit into Spyro 2.
Okay.
Just to start it off before I stopped for the night.
Okay.
Because part of me is, just gonna play all the Spyro games, in a row.
Oh, jeez. I can't do that.
I love doing the streams. It gives me a good motivation.
Yeah, I can see that.
Oh, Hub's online.
Yep. Spyro is not... I can't marathon games like that.
Let me see if Hub's getting more King Hearts.
Bear down. Oh, right, and then this warps me to Crash. Oh, God. Funnily enough, I feel like Bear Down has harder level design than Totally Bear, but you can also see, so I guess it's more understandable. Okay, that was almost bad. I feel like it's a bit understandable, I've noticed that in Crash games, in the dark levels, they tend to make the level design a bit more simplified to compensate for it. Usually, anyway. Not always, but... Nice. Short level though.
All right, so yeah, we're good. Me and Hub are good to continue our sessions.
Nice.
You'd be surprised how much more motivation I have of an audience.
How much what?
Motivation I have playing my games with an audience.
No, I can get that.
In fact, I kind of wish I could stream my Switch games just so I could
Yeah. I mean, streaming in general is just a good motivator to
play
specific games.
Yeah, right. I don't think Lewis would even be touching Monster Hunter if it wasn't for that.
Yeah, and even then, I don't think he streamed a
lot. You told me you wanted to do, Sunday, last week.
I don't want to sound mean, but I wouldn't put much stock into that stuff. What Lewis says.
No, I've learned. Anyways, I'm gonna jump the Hub's chat in about 20 minutes.
Okay.
Still, if you're still here, you didn't answer me if you started playing Xenoblade Chronicles 2 yet.
Oh. I don't know. Has he?
Well, that's what I'm waiting
Hooray for a really short secret.
Oh yeah, I started with the Ranger, but I haven't gotten far in it yet.
Fair enough.
Because when I started playing, I only played like a little bit up to Gormont, and then I just kind of stopped for like half a year because I was not in the right. I was not in the right mood.
Right. Yeah.
How far did you get so far? Can't go. I basically got past the first boss like an hour or so into the game. Was that Morag?
What? What happened there?
What happened there? I saw that too. I'm like, what?
That made no sense.
I'm trying to think about what would be the first boss that early. If it was about an hour, because like the only thing you think of is just the very first encounter with the only thing I think of is maybe like the first encounter of Malos.
Nice. That was so clean.
Malos? Oh wow, so yeah, it was Malos. Yeah, he barely got anywhere. Like, you only met like Pyra for like 5 minutes.
Nicely done, that was a clean level.
Oh man, I can just imagine like people like looking at like Pyrotypher Smash designs like and playing them in Smash first, then playing Xenoblade Chronicles 2 and just being like their original design. I mean, it's not nearly as bad with Pyra as it is with Mithra, but I still think their Smash designs both look better. I mean, it's pretty damn obvious with Mithra.
Tony Tiger from Serial. One interesting fact about Tiny is that his I don't know how well known this is, but in like early versions, his name was like Taz Tiger, which is interesting.
I am now controlling Fiora. You know, the unfortunate thing is we know why, but Fiora doesn't have much like aesthetic equipment.
Right. Oh, come on, do the spin jump, you stupid.
All right,
I can't. I'm assuming Nick's left.
Probably.
Oh my god.
Look at all this equipment that you can get for the characters, like for Fiora, you're never gonna have it for that long.
Yeah.
Look at it. Let me just look how these outfits look on her since.
Yay for messing around with the music. Owned.
Oh, I like this black version of Fiora's outfit.
Ooh,
let's
do that. Ooh, I like the end. Why? It was the end.
Dixon!
Bye.
Do you plan on continuing, like, soon? Just wondering.
Yeah, boy! Style on him. I love doing that. You can't do that in Insane, which is annoying, but... Yeah. Oh, you're playing P5R right now? That's cool.
Oh, where are you? Without spoiling too much in case Harry or anybody else here wants to do that.
Try to be vague.
Just say, number dungeon. How about that?
Yeah.
I'm about 12 hours so far. I just finished the first dungeon.
Okay.
Is that right?
I think the ceiling grate thing is faster in the originals.
Than it is in Insane?
Yeah.
Oh, the monkey
bars. The monkey, yeah.
You're always really nice with these darker colors.
Oh, good. Especially when you get invincibility, like, you go, zooming.
I'm at one of the best cutscenes in the game where, you know, Shulkin is invisible sandwich.
Oh, nice.
Remember that?
Yeah, no, I know what you're talking about.
That's one of my favorite jokes.
It's too hard to make, food be slowly eaten, so it's just...
Yeah, and they still do it, and it's still undefended.
Yeah.
My friend Kenda is playing Bayonetta 2.
Nice. That being said, I guess props for Kingdom Hearts 4 usually making the sea salt ice cream actually look like it's getting eaten.
Yeah, right. There it is. Yep, Shulkin is invisible sandwich. He's biting into it and not taking any bites out of it. It's almost like he's lying to Mira's face right now.
One, two.
Although, without saying too much, I do like. Without saying too much, I kind of wish on because I forget if this is like this in New Game Plus, that Fiora had the short hair look. Because I know, it's kind of weird how, how drastic characters look with different hairstyles.
Oh, yeah, no, I know. Seeing different hairstyles sometimes it just makes a character, just look completely, completely different.
I get that with that and glasses.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, that's the case in real life, too.
Yeah, right? I looked at myself in a mirror with and without my glasses, and I look like somebody else.
Yeah. Hashtag not my city goose.
Mm-hmm.
Totally fly.
Quest complete.
Completo. God.
The heart to heart right here. But what I'm going to do is save. And purposely fuck this up.
I'm so good at this game.
Yeah, I'm going to purposely fuck up this heart to heart.
Oh.
Well, it's because it's for an achievement.
Oh.
Heartbreak, I think it's called.
Right.
There was a time we watched the sunrise right here when we were quite young.
I do not miss how the original games handle these stages. Because you can barely see anything.
Well, I messed up the dialogue. Let me fix that. Load.
Loading.
All right, let me fix that.
Oh, skillage.
The skit is called Sunrise in the Park. It's like dusk right now.
Oh wait. Yes. Oh, that was good. That was good timing.
Achievement unlocked. Heartbreaking.
Okay.
Nice job!
Good job.
Let's not lose our heads, though. Brian's not even here.
Oh, no. Ha! Oh my god, okay. I don't know how I did that.
Piece of cake!
No sweat.
Oh, that's Sonic.
Yeah, that, it's too easy.
That was tight!
That was tied.
Yeah, that's what he said. Oh yeah, that's how he said in Japanese.
Yeah.
Is that in Euros or SAT specifically?
I think SAT.
I never read SAT English. He's like, that was tied.
Yeah.
It sounds so funny.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, speaking of Sonic, I did. I also want to stream Project 06 at some point as well, especially since I haven't played the Shadow stuff yet, and I'd like to
did
see
that.
Did
they recently finish that?
Hmm?
Did they recently finish that?
Yeah, they did the Shadow stages recently.
Man, you gotta love Sega for actually supporting this.
Yeah, right?
They're like, we know we fucked up, I know you guys can do better, we know you guys can do better, show us.
I mean, it's also the fact that, like, the fans don't have strict deadlines and other factors like that. They can just take as long as they need.
Yeah, and they also don't have, like, somebody like Nintendo breathing down their butts.
Yeah, so they can just do what they want, really. That's the thing you have to keep in mind with, company stuff, as opposed to, like, fan created content.
Chocolat's stuck on something and he's just jumping infinitely. I love it when AI does that.
They just screw up.
Especially when the AI in this game is not that good, to be honest.
Okay,
especially when you're outside of combat. Holy shit, they're stupid.
Yeah.
One of my favorite things to do is there's this pipeline outside of Colony 6. And there's like a river flow going out of it. So if you stand on it just right, like, you know, it's really funny watching like Shulk or Ryan just stand on the water flow and just keep falling off infinitely.
Yeah.
Oh, they just respawn on the water, so they just go back down again. It's hilarious.
Yeah.
If you watch Chugga, the AI does some really silly shit at times.
No.
Like, around the start of Matt the Forest, there's a, there's like a
There's like some of the bird enemies on like tree branch and all that. What happened was, I think he was playing as Sharla. So what happened was, Shulkin Dunban fell off the branch, but and the AI is trying to figure out how the hell to get back up.
Oh.
So they're just running around in circles like madmen.
Oh, but no, I know what you're talking about. Yeah, that was amazing.
I think I showed you that clip, too.
Yeah. Feeling good. Oh, what the heck? I can't read that in time, but thanks for the follow.
I missed it, too. I couldn't tell you, sorry. Alright, one more cutscene, and then I should go join Hub's chat. And luckily, it's the cutscene that's the most hilarious when you speed it up. Ryan with the Monado.
Yeah.
I love the high-pitched voice, Ryan!
Okay, that's fine. I can get the crystal on my way back.
Hello, Diego Oliver Akin Tanara, I think.
Hi.
Also, hi, I'm here.
I am here! All my theme bass boosted. Oh, come on, dude. So I think I need to go to the bounce box. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I just need this, and then I can go back.
Thank goodness for conveniently placed checkpoints.
Yeah. Oh, wait, no. That really doesn't stay down for long. I feel like they messed with a lot of the timings for like electric gates and stuff in Insane. The main thing I noticed specifically is in the future levels in 3, the laser gates don't stay active for as long, or like anywhere near as long as the original. Which is interesting. What is going on here?
I love backtracking.
Backtracking can be done well, but it's what? What did I miss? Are you kidding me?
No.
What the hell? I love this video game. It's probably some random TNT that just didn't get...
I don't know. Oh yeah! No, it's in a flash!
I'm sad.
Xenoblade girl.
I am very sad right now.
Hug.
Yay. I'm just gonna have to restart. There's no way I'm gonna be able to find that.
Ugh. Well. Oh yeah, this is like arguably one of the worst levels too.
Yeah, digging it nowadays, I think, is just the worst level in the game.
Even more than Cold Hard Crash.
No, because I Cold Hard Crash is like when you, especially when you know it's a fun challenge. Digging it is just dumb.
Well, because this thing has, like, all the bad stuff.
Yeah, because, like, the thing is a Cold Hard Crash is that, it's difficult, but it's not difficulty in, like the sense like, oh, you can't see or stuff like that. It's
right.
Yes, it is. They had a crater away from you.
Well, okay, I'll concede with that. But I mean, like, besides that,
that makes a little better.
Yeah, I'll give you that. But like, outside of that, there's nothing in Cold Hard Crush that's like difficulty for bullcrap reasons. This stage is just, it's just annoying. The backtracking part is just annoying, and like the bees don't help. Cause I actually like Cold Hard Crush nowadays.
Hungrybox and MKLeo played Nick All Stars Brawl versus the Five for $100. That's just like, bruh.
Man.
Yeah, but anyways, yeah, this pool is like has so many problems. It's long, it has a lot of crates. Is this the one that, I forget, is this the one that also has like the death root split?
Yes.
Yes.
But the one that has a bunch of nitros?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah, it has that. You know, you have to backtrack with, I believe, bees coming at you.
Yep.
Yes.
That's the main, the backtracking is the main thing, really, because if you play, if like you just go do a normal level run, don't go for the gem, it's not actually that bad. I mean, then again, like, a lot of Crash levels can be said like that.
Yeah.
Like, the in the trilogy, good. The only levels, that are really difficult as you just play, like, normally would be a good chunk of stages in Crash 1 because of the hardcore platforming. And I guess some of the vehicle stuff in 3. But other than that, it's like pretty easy.
I'm gonna save my game. Message hub.
Oh, so yeah, this. If I miss a box this time, someone please point it out. Because I genuinely don't know why I missed.
You know, it's funny. Me and a random thing. Me and Xavier were talking a bit this morning about how, we just realized that with a new Kirby game, we have to come up with a new way how Kirby's in debt.
I'm assuming Xavier's gonna record a Forgotten Land like launch.
Probably. Oh. Xavier told me Hub came up with the theory that Kirby did a lot of favors to get a 3D game, and now he owes.
That's brilliant.
Meanwhile, I tried saying, invested in city renovations, and it clearly didn't work. And now he's just seeing if he can find some property he can flip for easy money.
Yeah. That's amazing. Okay, there isn't another box up here, right?
Okay, you all started because it's just one stupid offhanded joke we made during our Kirby Superstar commentary up for C's.
Yeah, and it just became a running gag.
Yeah, right?
It
just gets funnier at this point.
Yeah, it's funny how that stuff kind of just happens on a whim, like the stupid Zay not stuck on a post. Like,
yeah, I think what happened was Hub just mentioned that he couldn't pay for the child support for Dynablade kids.
Oh,
yeah.
And that's how it just starts spiraling out of control.
Nice.
Like, I think the point of Great Kid Offensive was he's looking for money to pay off debt. But he couldn't keep all that money anyways. All right, Hub's waiting for me. All right, I'll see you guys then.
Okay. I'm start
bye, Jason.
Yeah.
Jason is leaving.
Ugh. No, not him. I'm saying because I'm itchy.
No, that's fine.
Oh. I will never speedrun this game.
Yeah.
Never.
I
feel like I mentioned this before. My brother just on a whim, like today, he did like a friggin'. He basically raced his friends. They were all playing Crash 3 in their own houses, and they just kind of raced to see who could beat Cortex first.
Was it just doing Cortex? Like, the whole game?
Just the main game. I don't think any of them would know about, like, the secret exits.
Oh, okay, so they're, like, just all the crystals and all that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, they took them, like, 3 hours to get through it anyways, I think. Trying to find everything else would be just way too long.
Yeah. How, often did they play the game?
They just played it. My brother doesn't really play Crash on the regular, so that...
Okay.
So I don't know about his friends. I don't know if that was their first time or not. That was just something they randomly did, like... Just something they randomly did, like, on the prelude to Christmas break in 2013.
Do you remember how they did, or... Like, besides, like, how long it took?
My brother... I can't remember what happened. I think he kept on losing on the motorcycle races.
Yeah, that's fair.
I didn't realize you could spin the bees back into the mines.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that doesn't really help with anything, but you can, I guess.
If this was Crash 4, this would be a mechanic needed to clear a path to get to the next gym.
Yeah.
Keep on forgetting that you can keep your gems and whatnot even if the boxes respawn.
Yeah, it's kind of funky.
Yeah, like I never trusted, which is why I never. I'm sorry, the seed bombs, like their hitboxes, always felt weird to me.
Yeah. Oh yeah, those bombs, like the hitboxes, like never made sense. Well, okay. That was weird.
I think I found a secret exit for this without getting all the stuff I needed, so I had to basically play through the level like twice. That was awful.
Yeah. It's a problem when you don't know what things are gonna do. Oh, good.
Oh, it's everyone's favorite level. Yeah, straight up, Warp Room 4 might be like just the most painful one to go through.
Yeah, I was talking about this in the last stream, but, I honestly feel like Warp Room 4 is the hardest world in the game. Because, like each one of these levels are pretty difficult in one way or another. And, like, when you go to Warp Room 5, there's Piston It Away, which is really difficult. And then, like, the levels after that, while they aren't necessarily easy, they're, like, a massive step down in difficulty compared to that.
Piston It Away is the bane of my existence.
Yeah. It is one of the hardest levels in this game, so...
I'm trying to think back. That's the... You have to backtrack in that one, don't you?
Yeah, it's the first stage in Warp Room 5.
Yeah, that's not fun.
My jump was not coming out properly, that was weird.
I need to keep a specific enemy alive so you can get up a ledge while backtracking. Yep. Crash 2 is a gift.
Well, if you do the glitch tie jumps, you don't need the enemy, but yeah. Oh damn it! I forgot. I died. Damn it.
So you're just gonna go through the level normally then?
No, I need to restart because I need the gems. I'm making better time than last time at least, but it's not the best. Oh well. If I don't mess up too much, I might... I don't want to just keep running this game, I want to move on eventually. Because I know this thing of speedrunners, like, they tend to, like, play the same game over and over again until like, they nail it down to, like, a T. I don't really want to do that. Like, I just want to have a decent run for my standards and just move on. I love doing that. only in the originals, because in Insane, I think they made the explosion radius bigger and also more immediate. So yeah, doing that in that version will just get you killed.
I mean, there's a fair chance that Vicarious Visions didn't even know you could do this in the original games.
Probably not.
Well, you can jump onto spinning penguins and hop off safely.
Yep.
The fudge!
It's not something you'd see often, because it's not really... It's not... usually practical, but it is a thing that can be done. Oh god.
Jeez.
Okay,
like there we that go. That friggin' broke. That thing would have, like, scrunched your backside.
Yeah. Look how fast you can go on the ice in this version, it's insane.
It's insane!
Yeah. Okay, so we're going back to get the boxes. Hit the checkpoint, so that saves me getting all the boxes. Get the gem back here, so we can then kill ourselves, and then just play the stage like normal.
That's a level of convoluted that Kingdom Hearts villain would blush at.
Yeah. Pretty much. Oh god. Yeah, we pretty much passed, and then this platform kind of doesn't like to work sometimes. Come on, just move, please. I don't know why it does this.
It knows what you're trying to do.
This should work. There we go. I don't know why it does that. I love the speed you can get. Sweet. Nice. And then we kill ourselves. Yeah, that is the safest way to do that, because if you hit the checkpoint and then go into the death route the first time, you're gonna have a much rougher time because like, the second time you go through there, the nitros and stuff will still be there, And you won't have any masks to help. Well, you'll have one mask in the death root itself, but that's basically it.
Ow.
That sucked. Yeah, we've cleared the bulk of the level now. Yep.
What is with this game?
With like the boxes just not being destroyed.
Yes, I do not recall them being this finicky when I played Crash 2.
Yeah. It's definitely a thing. Yeah, when was the last time you played OG, like the OG
2017.
Games? Oh. Why'd I do that? I'm making dumb mistakes. So are you gonna be around tomorrow?
I'll be trying to get up early to watch the Smash presentation, and I'll probably have to. I'm set for a job interview tomorrow around evening in my time zone, so we'll see what happens.
Okay. Yeah, I wanna, if I can like get set up in time, I'd like to be able to stream my reaction.
This porcupine is just the bane of all speedrunners' existence.
Yeah. God. Boop. Oh, this is a good instance of Nitro's not destroying boxes. In the original, this version, you have to go back there to hit the boxes. The Nitro's won't blow it up off screen. Whereas in Entain Trilogy, you can just ignore that box because it will get destroyed after hitting the switch. So it's kind of interesting how that works.
Oversight or deliberate malice?
Yeah, well, I mean, like, the, yeah, the way the Nitros work is that as you hit the switch, it only destroys the Nitros and not the boxes around them. And like that's fixed in Entain, so I don't know if that's the case in like Wrath or Cortex or whatever though.
Triangle.
Okay, that went okay, I guess. Minus the level restart. God. I don't know if I've said this on stream, but I do plan on, like, the next speed run I plan to do is a Crash 3 OG, so we'll see how that goes. Yeah, I like how you don't even need the green gem. Ah. Uh, Here's a random question for, like, everyone here. What levels in any of the three games would you say, this is more for me to get a good idea for what to do with the hard mode thing. But, like, what levels would you guys say, needs to be ramped up in difficulty?
None. Because I don't trust you.
Nice. That's amazing. But I guess like levels you thought that might have been a bit too easy that you want to be a bit more challenging.
No, I don't. I cherish the handful of times I don't get my ass kicked by this series. gosh, I don't know. Toad Village, if only because it's easier compared to the other trilogy games' first levels.
I mean, that's fair.
I don't know. Maybe Doubleheader could have some more bottomless pits or something.
That's fair. Yeah, I definitely want to make the medieval levels more challenging. I probably want to put a death route in Doubleheader because like that feels like the. That level feels like it should have one, but it just doesn't.
It's the. I don't know. I guess they just determined that the medieval levels would just be like breather levels.
Yeah. It's especially weird since Doubleheader is level 15. Like, it's. I don't know. It's a weird placement though.
The side effect of how Crash 2 and 3 functioned.
Yeah.
They don't, sequential levels don't necessarily ramp up in difficulty.
Yeah.
Just treat them like Robot Masters and Mega Man.
Pretty much. I don't know how I'm gonna do this necessarily, but I would like to somehow incorporate like the indoor medieval stuff from Cruft of Cortex as well. Like, I think that'd be neat.
I'm surprised no one's like tried to make just remake Cruft of Cortex Van Sane Trilogy's engine.
Yeah, I mean, what was it? Cogmonkey did remake Arctic Antics. I can speak. But like that's about it. It'd be cool to have like a full Cruft of Cortex remake in N-Sane style, yeah.
Whereas no one's like done like recreated. I hate that platform placement.
Yeah.
I love her dicks.
Yeah. But if you have any levels you have in mind as well, Sylph, let me know.
I'm surprised people haven't tried to recreate the GBA levels, considering they share so much, like, architecture with the PS1 games.
I didn't even think about that. That gives me an idea to maybe incorporate some stuff from, like, those, like, games. Especially since they already, like, share a lot of themes from Crash 2 and 3 anyway.
Yeah, and Trance was gradually beginning to move away from that.
Yeah.
Like, you could see a bit of Wrath of Cortex influence in, like, fire levels, I guess.
Yeah.
Still used trilogy music though.
Some decent remixes at least.
I would have liked to have heard them. I actually don't know who composed for the GBA games, but
yeah, I would
have liked to have heard Vicarious Visions interpretations of like the Wrath of Cortex OST.
Well, that would have been cool. Dude. That was a weird hitbox on that mask.
I'm not used to the mask just being out in the open outside of Crash 1.
Yeah. Yeah, because Crash 1, it does it, like, all the time. In this game, it does it, like, a few times, and then Crash 3, it never does it. Yeah, it's kind of weird, though. Okay.
Alright.
Oh yeah, I haven't mentioned this much on... I don't think I mentioned this out, like, much, if at all, on camera, but one thing I also want to do is try and see if I can come up, like, create, like, original level themes. Like, I don't know how that would work, but if I can figure that, like, something out, that I feel like that would be a good way to stretch my creative muscles and not be restrained to like what's already there. So that could be fun.
Is there, were there actually any crates beyond that purple gem?
Nope. I don't...
So you can literally just quit at any time.
Yeah, a decent, like, amount of them, I guess, kind of feel a bit weird, because you just do, like, 5 seconds of it, get the gem, and then you can just kill yourself and move on. Like, I don't understand the reasoning for making a game like that.
I guess, I don't know, your reward for finding the secret, or these were programmed in at the last second.
Maybe.
I can believe, honestly, either.
Yeah. Because it's something I've noticed, like, when I go from Crash 2 to 3, like 2, like, does that whole thing, and then I noticed when you go to 3, like, they don't tend to do that anymore. They tend to have the gems at the end of the secret paths instead, so you can't do that. So it's kind of interesting. Okay.
I didn't notice that. Oh my gosh.
I guess the slide increased my hitbox.
That is a sentence. Oh gosh, I'm getting nostalgic to play some PS1 games right now.
Yeah, it's nice to revisit like the old classics sometimes. I wish I had like my old PS1 library, because I don't really have any of them anymore.
Where is my... Our PlayStation 3 is somewhere in a box right now. I should probably hook it up. I can buy something on it while the store is still up.
Yeah.
I should buy Parasite Eve.
Oh yeah, we had someone talking about that in the chat earlier.
Someone was talking about Parasite Eve.
Yep. they were recommending I do a speedrun of it, of the... For some reason.
Oh no, I don't want a speed run. I want like a slow burning horror session.
Yeah, I'm not gonna promise I'm gonna play that game.
I'm not even like, yeah, you're gonna have to either find an old copy or download it off the PS3's classic store. If I had the tech, I would stream it myself.
That'd be interesting.
I'm curious about it.
Yeah.
Like, gosh, it's...
Oh, I don't know why this... I just thought of this, but... I guess now that Superstar's over, we can find time one day to start doing the Clone Wars streams.
We're not doing the arena?
I don't know. I'm not too fussed about that either way. I mean, if you want to do that, I guess we could, but...
I mean, I can't promise we'll win, but...
Yeah. Yeah, I've just been on a weird Star Wars kick lately. I don't know why. I've been, like, watching a lot of random, like, videos and stuff. Laser. Nice. That was very clean. Oh, game. Can we please stop freezing? Okay, I'm gonna save my game after this fight because I don't feel comfortable with how it's freezing like that.
Yeah, it didn't even occur to me that you weren't saving.
Yeah. Ah, damn it. It's really hard to get both of these shoulder parts like off at the same time. Kit. Oh my god.
Oh gosh, I forgot they sent missiles sideways.
Yeah. Yeah, having, like, your full moveset in the insane version of this fight makes this quite a bit easier.
I don't know why they took away Crash's ability to crouch.
Yeah, it's really weird. Although it's really, from what I remember, it's like really weird looking, like doing a slide jump in Insane, and then like as you're like still like moving in the air, like Crash can still throw the Wumpa Fruit. Like it doesn't look right. Oh god. Oh yeah, funny thing about these enemies here. It doesn't matter where you hit them, you just need to be sliding. So that's why I didn't take damage there.
I'm learning all sorts of new things right now.
There's a thing in Insane as well. Oops.
Oh, it made this so much easier.
Well, actually, I can do this. Ah. Okay, I gotta be careful. I can't die now.
Oh gosh, these things are the bane of my existence.
Yep.
Also... I realize a lot of these enemies just don't have names.
Yeah, like, what are these things? Like, with the weird octopus things.
I don't know.
Yes, weird. Okay, here we go. Oh! Gosh. Damn it. That was too slow. Yeah.
Okay. Schmuck bait.
Okay, this bonus room is pretty interesting because it's a lot more awkward in Insane because of the difference in the jump physics. Whereas in this version, it's like really easy. You just do a simple jump. That's kind of just what happens when you like have different game physics, but with the same level design.
Like, what game did Vicarious Visions use as the baseline for Crash's physics in Insane Trilogy?
I don't know, because it feels like a mix. Because going through the actually, I don't know. I think the most, it feels the most like this game, I guess, but like, also, I don't know, it's really, whatchamacallit, gravity isn't as, I don't even know what I'm trying to say.
Oh gosh, but you can spin them?
Yep.
I hate this game.
it makes them so much easier to deal with. Oh god.
Something about the... I didn't realize you could just spin them lap assistance instead of just trying to slide into them.
No, oh, yeah. I tend to just, like, slide spin them because that more or less counts as two hurts.
That would have helped me a lot playing this game.
Oh, that was close. I almost messed them up. Okay. Yeah, we're making good time. I honestly, if Warp Room 5 goes well, I think I'll just... this will probably be my last run of this game for a while. And yeah, I'm just getting all the hard, like the main platforming stuff out of the way. Oh god. Oh, here's another game I keep on forgetting that I want to do. I also want to stream Mirror's Edge at some point. I keep forgetting about that, but like. I've seen LPs of that game before and it looks really fun. So I'd like to do that.
I'm just like looking at the Crash breaking the laws of dimensions right now.
Yeah. That's only possible in this.
You can do this.
Yeah, it's only possible in the originals. You can't do that in Insane. Oh god. That was almost really bad.
Why was a yellow platform not waiting for you?
I don't know, that's the first time I've seen that happen. Don't know. Yeah, I have no idea why that did that. Oh god. Ugh!
I didn't realize the laser discs from this game are... They're in the future levels in Crash 3, aren't they?
Are they? I don't know.
Well, actually... Like, there's a Labus is an enemy that kind of has a similar function.
Oh, that, yeah. I think it's probably, like, the same, or, like, a similar model. Like, just repurposed for the UFO enemies.
I mean, yeah, these levels feel like dry runs for the future levels to begin with.
Yeah, I can see that. I'm surprised that worked. Oh, okay, yeah, that was my fault.
Oof.
So I guess, since it's on everyone's mind at the moment, how are you feeling for the Smash reveal tomorrow?
It's time.
Yeah. That sounds about right. I'm just glad to...
I don't know who it is!
Yeah.
But I'll just try to enjoy the presentation.
I'm so ready to just have this ride over at this point. Like, it's been a fun ride, but like... we've extensively had, like, a Smash hype train going on since, like, 2013. Because it hasn't, like, even after Smash 4, there wasn't really much of a break. So this is, good. This has been quite a long road. That, it's a bit bittersweet to be at the end of it, but at the same time, I'm kind of excited to just... be able to stop thinking about it so much. And again, this also means that, okay, oh, damn it, dude. Happy and sad that it'll be over tomorrow. That's basically my mindset now. Yeah. Because like we are not getting another Smash game for at least another 5 years, and I feel like that's being generous. Like I don't think we need another game for a while. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I can just break these. And, I guess, with that being said, Brawl will be happening, starting soon as well. I don't know when exactly, because, I do want to do other things first. Especially since I recently, since I splurged a bunch of money, one of those games was Puyo Puyo Tetris 2, because I still need to stream that, and I'd like to do that before Brawl, at least. So that'll happen. I assume it won't take that long, because those games aren't really that long. And then... Brawl will happen, like, late this month, or, like, early November. I'm probably gonna have to have time for like longer streams for Brawl compared to like what we had for like Melee, because otherwise that game's just never gonna end. Like, there's so much stuff in that game, it's ridiculous. For some reason, I don't feel like Smash 3DS is going to take too long, though. I could be completely wrong about that, but I almost like completed that game before Smash Wii U came out, and it didn't really... I don't remember it taking very long. I could be wrong. I know for a fact Smash Wii U is going to take forever, though.
What if I say, like, call in breakfast tomorrow?
Oh, what? Get the gem, please. But I'm also expecting Sakurai to do a farewell speech or whatever, like something, you know how in like after when Smash 4 ended, there was the whole like this is the final count of characters and stages and like all this other stuff. I'm expecting something similar to that in this direct or presentation, whatever you want to call it, because it's gonna. Like, the amount of stuff in this game is absurd.
I want another Everyone Is Here trailer.
Yeah, I would like that. Just, like, as a final hurrah. Like this is the final trailer. There's no, like, secrets here or anything. Like, don't expect anything new, but, like, it's just... We want to have some fun, so let's remake the Everyone Is Here trailer with all the DLC included. Like, I would like to see that. That would be fun. Because that is still... I feel like that's the best Smash trailer we've probably ever had. Like, just... That, like, the Everyone Is Here, like, there was something just magical about that.
Yes, that was something. Just that entire E3 segment was just a friggin' happy fever dream.
Yeah. I am a little bit sad, in a way, though, because, it did get semi-spoiled for me, because I remember specifically just... turning on my phone that day, and I just immediately saw on my feed a new Smash game called Smash Bros. Ultimate is going to include all the previous fighters in the series, and I'm just like, I don't know if this is a prank or not, but okay. I'm kind of upset that got spoiled for me.
Always request segmented links ahead of time.
Yeah.
Don't go to social media, don't go to YouTube, just go to your DMs.
That's the thing though, it wasn't even social media, it was, first off, do you have a phone, Scrappy?
Yes, I have a phone.
Okay. what happened is, I just opened up Google Chrome, and like, there's... when I do that, there's basically just a list of just random news about things, just about random things. Usually things I'm interested in, and other times it's just random garbage. And like, the first thing I saw when I looked at it was just Smash Ultimate and like all and like that stuff. Like, it was like the first thing I saw when I looked when I went on it, and it was just kind of annoying. Not much I could have done about that, which is a shame, but it is what it is. Yeah, if I didn't see that ahead of time though, I probably would have gone ballistic. Cause I watched that trailer so many times, before release.
Watching so many reaction videos, YouTube was recommending me ones in Japanese.
Oh god.
Good times.
Yep. I'm gonna miss this. Experience. Like, obviously it's gonna come back into, like, eventually, whenever they do another Smash game, but, you know. Who knows when that will be. And I prefer not to think about that for a while, but, you know, still. Let's just, all I can really say now, right now about it is just, let's try and treasure these final moments while we can. Because we don't know when we're gonna have this again.
Yep. I'm not sure if we'll ever. It's been surreal to say the least.
Oh, definitely. Okay. Yeah, all we can really do is just wait for the inevitable now.
Yeah, I'm heading to bed relatively early for once.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna, like, after the stream, I'm probably gonna get, well, not right away, but I'm probably gonna wind down for the night. Yeah. Get an earlier sleep. Honestly, more than anything, this stream was not only just because I wanted to just get a better time on this game, but I also just wanted to pass the time.
I might just watch some Smash trailers when this is done.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Oh, speaking of trailers, one thing I thought about doing in the Smash streams, starting with Brawl, is that, like, at the end of each session, I wanna watch one of the trailers, and then, you know, just keep, like, it'll just be like a thing we'll do at the end of each stream. The thing with Brawl is that there's only, like, 5 of them or something, so it's not that many. But, like, when we get to Smash Wii U and Ultimate, we'll have a lot more things to watch. I just think that'll be a fun thing to do.
That would be fun. We can spin the asteroids?
Yep.
I've been playing this game wrong.
Oh, the game's over. I think I shaved off, like, yeah, a decent amount. Not the best still, but I'll level 227.
Crash, what do you suppose happened to Cortex? And what about the Cortex Vortex? It's still up there.
And, whenever I get to, speedrunning Crash 3, we'll see what my time can be for that. It is a little bit jarring.
Is it... The satellite has a very similar shape to Cortex's old blimp.
Yeah. That is a good point. Yeah, after I do the Crash 3 speedruns, I think I think that'll be it for speedrunning Crash games for me for a while. Cause I've done quite a lot of running these games in both the OG and Insane. So yeah, I don't wanna keep doing this for like ages. I do wonder what happened to Embryo during like Warped though, because like after this game he kind of just vanished.
He ruined Cortex's life temporarily and he peaced out.
Yeah, pretty much.
So. I do find it weird they don't credit Brendan O'Brien for Crash's vocalizations.
I just realized, by the way, that I didn't actually save, so I'm glad the game didn't screw up on me.
Yes, yeah, I'm glad too.
That's good. I might have to be a bit more careful with Crash 3 though, because that game has it's a disc copy I have, and I've had that game crash on me a few times. Funny joke, I know.
Why was the like projector about to play again?
Oh, that's because it was gonna be Embryo talking.
Would you like to do the? Oh, they showed you the bad ending first, even though you had all the gems.
Yeah, you have to see the bad ending first. Like I end the timer after Cortex because I already have everything at that point anyway. So yeah. No, I feel like just having the timer go for the first credits up to the second, the like true ending is just kind of stupid. There's no reason for that.
Yeah, Ryo, he ruined Cortex's life. He's not really a good guy, so he has no concern about what Uka Uka is doing. So he peaced out and went to go take speech lessons.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess it's fair.
Like, Brio shows up in 5 out of 8 mainline games, but I don't consider him a main character.
Yeah, I'm still kind of... I don't know, I don't want to say miffed, but I'm still a little bit disappointed in how he was in It's About Time after, like, how, like... how great he was in Mind of a Mutant. Like, that's still, like, that characterization is probably still like the best in the series.
Yeah, it was pretty funny. Like, there's there's like potential in just having Cortex and Brio be like these begrudging frenemies.
Yeah.
Honestly, I'm like weirdly itching to play Mind of a Mutant or at least watch its cutscenes again.
I wouldn't be opposed to playing that game again.
Vicky Winters, we miss you.
And that's the game. So, yeah. I'm pretty happy with... I'm overall pretty happy. I had some annoying hiccups, especially stuff like missing boxes and digging it. Like, that was kind of crap, but... besides that, it was a decent run overall. And, maybe if I feel like it in the far future, I might do another run of this game, but... As for now, I think I'm done. So... expect. Yeah, next time I speedrun anything, it'll be crash free OG. And then yeah, we'll see how that goes. So I guess for now, everyone just prepare yourselves for the Smash reveal tomorrow. Yeah.
Yep, have a good night, folks.
Yeah, good night, everybody.